we have been compelled to create a permanent armaments industry of vast proportions. How to do this? 3.5 million men and women are directly engaged in the defense establishment. We annually spend on military security alone more than the net income of all United States corporations. Now, this conjunction of an immense military establishment and a large arms industry is new in the American experience. The total influence, economic, political, even spiritual, is felt in every city, every state house, every office of the federal government. We recognize the imperative need for this development, yet we must not fail to comprehend its grave implications.
Third largest exporter of arms after the US and Russia.
In 2014, and accounted for 1/10 of the total sales on the list, the top Russian seller was Almazante.
Syrian government soldiers, including 9 Russians, have been killed in an attack, according to the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights.
A U.S. Army soldier died and 2 others were hurt in a Taliban attack in Afghanistan.
Civilians, again, the victims after a Saudi-led coalition airstrike in Yemen.
At least 2 U.S. soldiers have been killed in an apparent suicide bombing in the Syrian city of Manbij.
At least 9,000 Rohingyas died. At least 6,700 were killed, including more than 700 children under the age of 5.